Morning, everybody. Good morning from Grace Assembly in Palmar. We're just going to let everybody kind of get on for a little bit. We're up and live. We're just going to let you get connected a little bit here. Let you get on. Just give you, we're going to give you a few minutes to get on. Morning. Hope you all are getting on this morning. I just want to open up in a word of prayer before we get going. I just pray if you're in your living room in your house right now, just get free, get ready, get in, get the family, bring everybody in together, and we're going to worship. We're gonna worship the Lord. The word's going to come, and we're excited this morning. This is different. We realize that coming in this morning. I love the people being here and coming in. There's only four of us here. So we're not breaking any rules. We're going with it. But you know who's here? The Holy Spirit.
That's right.
And He is in your home today. I was just praying earlier. Every Monday night we've come to prayer. No matter what we're praying on, God has touched my heart about the homes. And I thought, God, you know, we're praying over the homes. I get it, the homes. I know the homes. But I kept hearing every Monday night the homes. And He reminded me this week, Darren, I've told you to be praying for the homes. This is a moment of the homes. This is a moment. God wants to do a work in your home.
Amen.
He wants to do it in your house. Maybe you're somebody watching today and you've never even acknowledged anything about church or anything. Today could be your first day.
Right.
Today's a new day for this pastor. We're doing it through technology. I'm looking at empty pews, but not out there. Your house is full. It's you and your family. So we're speaking to you today. We're asking for God's Holy Spirit to come and fill your room. Lord, we just thank you today. I thank you for this moment. We thank you, Father, for what you're going to do through this service at this time. God, I thank you. Bless every home, every ear out there that hears me today, God. Everything hears us sing, hears us bring the word, Father. Your work in their lives. We just believe for it. We thank you, Jesus, for your great work. Holy Spirit, come. In Jesus' name. Everybody said, and I can hear you out there, amen. Praise God. Let's worship.
God, we praise you this morning, God. We give you glory and honor. You're worthy, yes, you are. You're worthy. We praise you, God. We praise you, God. Have your way. All my life you have been faithful.
Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. I break out, surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. Your goodness is running out. It's running after me. With my life laid out, surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running out. It's running after me. All my life you have been faithful.
Let heaven come.
Let heaven come. Let heaven come. Let heaven come. Let heaven come. Let heaven come.
Let heaven come.
Oh, let heaven come. Sing yours. Have yours. It's a king.
No place.
control.
Sitting in your home and think to yourself, this is different. Well, I agree. It's your
Pastor, if you're out there and you don't have a church and you're tuning in right now, and Pastor here at Grace, this today is different. It's different. But I'll tell you what, I think we move and be flexible when the Holy Spirit wants to do in the midst of whatever's happening, whatever's going on as a church. The church itself, it's not a building or walls. It's the body of Christ.
Amen.
And I see it. I am so stirred right now that I see so many different ones going through my feet. I said it Tuesday, and I say it now. Even this morning, looking to see those that are going live, sharing the word, worshiping. Praise God. Thank you for those pastors and those churches today as they come together and do what we're able to do and give praise. I just throw it out there. If it comes to the point where they're saying that we got to be at home and that's it for a minute, that ain't going to stop us. We'll do this from home somehow. We'll make it happen.
Right.
Praise God. We're going to worship. We're going to worship anyway. Amen?
Yes.
We're going to worship and we all can come together. I encourage you today, leave your comments. Leave comments and praise reports.
Yes.
Later on, I'm going to be reading those and trying to connect with you. And throughout this week as your pastor, I'm going to be connecting with those from Grace here and asking any needs. Anybody out there has any needs, we want to be able to help and reach in any way that we can.
Amen.
Just thank the Lord for all his goodness. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you today for this word.
Thank you,
Father. Let it pierce our hearts. Let us, Lord, today take it.
Yes.
God, let us take it, take this word today and apply it to our life.
Yes.
Lord, I thank you, Father, for all those listening. Everybody that hears my voice.
Yes.
Lord. I'm just reminded how big God you are.
Yes,
you're
you
a
are.
Big God.
Yes, you are.
You're a big God. You're bigger than all this.
Yes.
You're bigger than all this, and you will not be stopped.
That's right.
God, your word will go out.
Yes.
Your praise, we just gave you praise.
Yes.
God, we continue,
yes.
God, in our lives. As we stay faithful, God, those that are up right now, God,
yes.
In their homes, Lord, thank you, Father, the home.
Continue
thank you, God, what you're doing.
Yes.
Rising up
yes.
In your homes.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
Your grace,
thank
your peace
Father.
Over
yes.
Here in Jesus'
yes.
Name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Title of my message today, I heard it Monday. I heard the word source. Source. And God will speak those kind of things to me, give me a word, and I start chewing on it. Throughout the week, I knew where I was headed. The source. Source, I looked up the definition of it, is a place, a person, or thing from which something comes or can be obtained. The source. Now, if you've got your Bibles, I'll give you a second there to turn to the Gospel of John, chapter 4. John 4. I'm going to hang out in that chapter a little bit today. I won't go long. I'm going to hang out there a minute, and that's where we're going to be for our scripture today. John 4, 13 and 14. I'm going to read from there right now. Jesus said to her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty again. The water that I will give him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Growing up, I think about the source. Growing up, I grew up in a little trailer with me and my mom. Little bitty trailer, man. A bedroom was a cracker box, so I always called it. If I got out of the bed and was to run, I'd have hit the wall. I mean, I got out, there's a wall, there's another wall. It's a tight little room. It was a little much bigger than enough for my bed and my dresser, but we made do. God was good in that trailer. There was prayer meetings in that trailer that rocked that trailer.
Amen.
My mom held prayer meetings there, and as a kid, it didn't faze me at all that there'd be a room full of people out in the living room praying, seeking God, and I grew up around that became natural in my life. I challenge you in your home. What's becoming natural in your home?
Yes.
Are your kids experiencing that?
Yes.
Are your kids being able to see that you're praying? Do they see in the middle of this moment right now that you're going to look to God and pray? They need to see that.
Amen.
They need to see that in your home. So encourage your kids in prayer. Come together and pray over what's going on right now. But in the middle of that trailer, that little bitty trailer, the main thing that stuck out to me about it, even as a kid being curious about something, was this concrete cistern. It was a concrete cistern outside. And that was our water. That was what held our water. When I mowed, I was mowing at about the age of 6 or 7. The mower itself, I was tall enough that I had to use the bottom handle with one hand, the half handle, not really a handle, it's just a brace for the handle, in the top. So I was a little fella pushing mowing. I wanted to do my part and help mom. And so again, I pushed mowing, but I always remember mowing around that sister. I had to be careful. I didn't want the blades hitting on the concrete. I'm really going back here. We didn't have a weed eater, so we went out with scissors. and trimmed around the cistern, kept the grass down around it. But the cistern, as a kid, was really, it was important to me. There are a lot of things happening around that cistern. I got a brand new wallet one time from Holiday World. And I think it had the Incredible Hulk. I had a Holiday World with Santa Claus on it, and then I had an Incredible Hulk. That wallet was it. It was a black wallet with white. It came around the side, kind of like a strap through it, weave through it. That thing came up lost. Man, I got a punishment and a half. My mom laid into me. I was losing everything all the time. And I lost that wallet, and I'll tell you what, that cistern became an important place. Because I'm out in the yard after a punishment. I don't remember the length of time. I don't remember how much time it went past after getting punished for losing stuff. I found that wallet. Boy, what a time that was, walking that wallet with my mom and saying, I found it. But I'd already had the punishment. It's probably something I might say I held over a head for a while, many years, to bring back up the wallet and the punishment I got. But I found it. That sister was important to me. I found the wallet by that sister. That sister was important because that was our water. I remember when it would get low, we know the time mom would call and the water truck man would come. I sound like an old fella here, don't I? I'm going to be 48. I'm not that old. But the water truck would come. The guy would come with the big tanker truck, and it was like an exciting moment. He was going to drag the hose, and I was excited to see how everything worked. There was a little concrete part where they had made the concrete and put a handle of rebar where you can lift that little piece up to put the hose down in. And every now and then when nobody's around, I'd lift it up and look down there. This was heavy. We had to struggle to pull that out of there. But I always knew, don't be getting down in there. That'd be dangerous, fall down in the cistern. But I watched the waterman come and fill it up, and that was our water. And I remember moments about the cistern that when it got down low, we knew we needed to clean it. We'd let it get down low, and we'd get down in it. The water's small, we'd clean it. We'd scrub it. We'd clean it up. This is our source. This is our water. Do you know, out of that water, the one thing I'm thankful for, out of that knowing that that was our source and we had to have our water, I don't remember a bottle water. I don't believe it existed then. If water was in a bottle, you could have took a Pepsi bottle, glass to the sink, and that would have been your water bottle from the tap. That was our water. But I am so thankful in the house that I grew up in, that even though I know that we had to have water, and that was our water, and I didn't know what a shower was. I don't know the first time I really took a shower. It was always baths. And I'm pretty sure, without my mom here asking, I'm pretty sure that was because to save water. A shower's going to run a little longer. So all I knew was a bath. There was things mom did to save and conserve because that cistern was our source of water.
Right.
But I'm thankful in the midst of that and knowing that it was our wife and it was Jesus Christ.
Right.
And she raised me up in that house and things would come about that we needed or had to have. She showed me in her life what was going to exist and what was going to go forward was the power in on Jesus. Was her calling out to him. Was her, me as a kid, even knowing that my mom didn't make a lot. Knowing that her leaning, those prayer meetings said more to me than to know. I knew if that water tank ran out, there's still a source that we were going to be reaching to on Skyer Drive Road in Corden, Indiana. That was Jesus Christ,
right.
Holy Spirit filled,
yes.
In our life, taking care of us at every moment.
Yes.
I would hear my mom tell testimonies of reaching into her wallet and knowing there was 20s that she didn't have there. I believe the Holy Spirit can do. He can multiply.
Yes.
In your giving and you're being faithful and you trust in him, he'll show you. You can't outgive God.
Right.
And I'm telling you, I'm thankful for the source that my mom showed me. It wasn't just about that water. I would have thought in the original part of thinking that, man, well, that's our water. It was a big thing, the water chunk of it. But how many knows how many moments in life when we come and around a church service and lean in on God, that when he come, the Holy Spirit come and fill, it was much bigger than the water truck showing up. When we went to the service and we went to talk about Jesus, and we went down to the Little Mall Catholic Church and we got in and we pressed into things. Holy Spirit came. It was a much bigger feeling than what the water truck could ever bring.
Right.
In that church, when we go back, I had times in the driveway of that source being what I needed, that source of the Holy Spirit. She showed me as a young boy, when we sit in the car for 3 hours, what kid sits in the car for 3 hours and just prays and the Holy Spirit in tongues and let God move upon his life? I'm thankful that I have mom that showed me
yes.
the source.
Yes.
I want to talk to you about the source today. The source is Jesus. The source is Jesus. It's Jesus. Say it with me.
Jesus.
It's Jesus. It's him. Has this woman come to the well? Jesus said to her, everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty again.
Amen.
The water that I will give him will become in him a spring of water rolling up to eternal life. In these minutes, I think about the source. Think about the source. When Jesus is talking to this Samaritan woman, she's even surprised that he would be talking to her. Let's go back to verse 7. We'll go up to verse 7. A woman of Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." For his disciples had gone away into the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How is it that you, a Jew, ask for a drink from me, a woman of Samaria? For Jews have no dealings with Samaritans." Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that is saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you have nothing to draw water with, and the well is deep. Where do you get that living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob? He gave us the well and drank from it himself, and did his sons and his livestock." And this is verse 13, our key verse today. But Jesus said to her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty again. The water I give from him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." Say eternal life.
Eternal life.
The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I will not be thirsty or have to come here to draw water." Jesus said to her, "Go, call your husband and come here." The woman answered, "I have no husband." Jesus said to her, "You're right in saying I have no husband, for you have five. You're the one now is not your husband. What you have said is true." The woman further down in 21, Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem will you worship the Father. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming and is now here, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father is seeking such people to worship him." Amen. The Father today is seeking those such people to worship him. Him being the source. Him being the source. As he gives from the well, he's saying, "I'm the one. I give the everlasting." I think about the water that the source we draw today, but from Jesus Christ. And it leads up, as the scripture says, to eternal life.
Yes.
In these moments that I watch, and I don't make light of any of this. The whole time that I've seen this, and I'm not to pinpoint anybody, but when I've seen jokes, and there are times that I've seen this made me chuckle, and I know it. But we need some light moments because things are heavy. But we do need to be careful because there are family members that are losing people.
Yes.
At church, we got to be careful. People, we got to be careful what we say and do, because somebody else, on the flip side, it's come close to home already, right? I mean, we've seen it from far away and thought it was nothing, and then it's here.
Right.
We got to be considerate of those compassionate for those that are hurting through this. But I don't make light of any of that when I bring up this. I went to Wikipedia when I see what's been happening in the news. I went to Wikipedia and I looked up toilet paper. I've seen all this hype of getting that and stocking up, and I'm just curious. Wikipedia says one tree produces about 200 rolls. I thought to myself, man, there's some of you out there sitting on a tree at your house right now. You hauled in a whole tree. You hauled in, you got 200 rolls and you got a whole tree in your house.
Right.
83 million rolls are produced per day. If any of you got 83 million rolls, shame on you. There's nothing wrong with stocking up, and I'm going to talk about that today. Today is not an episode, and I'm not talking about how things were made. But I'm just curious, where is the source of this toilet paper we're reaching for? What's its source? It's the trees. I happen to be in a job at Hillrick and Bradsby, local Sutter, making ball bags. Well, guess what? That's where they come from, too. And just this week, we're going to be on an undetermined time of being off. And I'm thankful for my job, watching out for us and making good decisions. And I'm thankful for that. And I'm gonna take this time that God's given, and I work for the church too. And God's gonna bless it. And
yes.
I'm gonna be reaching. And I'm looking for the source.
Yeah.
I'm looking at the source. I do know that to being a prepper, there's nothing wrong with that. Those of you that prep, I think we should have a stock of things. I think we should be smart. I think we should be looking to that. But like I say, today's not an episode of how things are made. I'm just curious, as we're reaching for this, as we're reaching for this item of toilet paper being the hot topic that we have to have, what's its source? It's the trees. Well, you know, God's made all this. He's made the trees.
Right.
The birds of the air. He's faithful in it all.
Yes,
and he's covered in each one of these areas.
Right.
And I think, what is my source? What is it I'm running to? When I think about prepping, that's not a bad thing. Have your stock. But I think to myself, it's wisdom to have that, but I can have, and there's where the buck comes in, it's right here. I can have a truckload of ammo, I can have a room full of toilet paper, and a truckload of tuna and soups and water. I can have all that in my house and still not have a piece.
Right.
Still not have a picture out there today. And I'm talking to those that right now, it's sensitive. This is sensitive to you. Those of you that maybe you already had a fear of being out around people anyway. Maybe those of you that you about washed the hide off your hands to begin with.
Right.
You sanitized just from being out in regular public before this ever came.
Right.
And I know the enemy of our souls, Satan himself, calling you right who he is. I want to use this to bind you up and tie you up and keep you literally in the spirit from being able to get anywhere in your life and hold you back when this clears up, hold you back further than what he already had.
Right.
I'm telling you today, the source is not in our toilet paper. The source is not in what we can stock up. It's not in ammo. It's not in cancer. Which those things are wise. I don't think we need a truckload of toilet paper. I think whatever God gives you, we're going to go and be smart and add to our stock and keep things back and be ready when things do shut down. If things happen like that, we'll have something to reach for. That is wisdom.
Yes.
In your finances, it's wisdom.
Yes.
But those of you the enemy's trying to tie up, and those of you that are strong in your faith, that are watching or seeing, being compassionate to those around you.
Right.
To those that are hurting. This is a moment that we call out to our neighbors. It should have always been. But now we're to the point now we got to be checking on people. We got to know.
Right.
We don't see them out. We got to know. We can't go by that. We can't go by, I haven't seen the neighbor out. You probably aren't going to see them. Your neighbor's going to be laying low. We're going to be bunkered down. We've got to reach for each other. What is our source in the middle of this? And have all the drinking water in the world, all the bottled water, but it's the Holy Spirit.
Right.
I need my life and what Jesus
has
called to me and what he's done. He's more. He's more than any of that. He's more than any of that. You're there today and you think, Aaron, I'm not sure how this is going to play out. I'm not sure what's going to happen out of this. You know, I'm not either. I don't know exactly how it's going to play out, but I know. And I trust the Heavenly Father that he's got it covered.
Amen.
That's where the key word comes in today. If you don't know Jesus Christ, and when I say that, I want to be clear.
Right.
Have you asked him to come into your heart?
Right.
Have you asked him to come into your life today?
Well, he is. That's right.
If you haven't, today is your moment. Today is your time. Today it could be a start of something you're doing different you've never done before. As I talk and I talk about Jesus, as I mention his name, did you hear me talk about him at a well, talking to a woman he wasn't even supposed to talk to? That the world would have said, you had no business. What are you doing talking to her?
Right.
That same Jesus wants to talk to you.
Amen.
That same Jesus is offering you eternal water, eternal life,
yes.
Eternal life through him. You'll never thirst again. Grabbing after Jesus, going after Jesus, asking him into your life, walking with him. You'll never thirst again. I want to read the words to a song that my wife's going to play here in a minute. It's called Rescue. The title of it. It says, you are the source of life. I can't be left behind. No one else will do. I will take hold of you. I need you, Jesus. My heart is yours for life. I need your hand in mine. No one else will do. Lord, I put my trust in you. I need you, Jesus, to come to my rescue. Where else can I go? There's no other name by which I am saved. Capture me with grace. I will follow you. My heart is yours for life. I need your hand in mine. No one else will do. Lord, I put my trust in you. I need you, Jesus, to come to my rescue. Where else can I go? There's no other name by which I'm saved. Capture me with grace. I will follow you. Today, as we've talked about the source, he is the source of your life. Of all those things, materials we can stock in our home, those are important. But my concern today, and what God wants you to hear today, even the Christian that's watching today, church-going Christian, you're in here every week. Where's your source? What are the things you're reaching for? In my life, in my past, there was an empty void. When the moment I turned from Christ and backslid, when I walked away from him, ran in my life, it was running. It was a run. I reached for so many other things to try to fill. It really was. When I look back at it, it was an empty void in my life I was trying to fill with stuff. Drugs, drinking, all those items. But in our life, as we get past it, and if you're here today and you have those addictions, he can take those things. He wants to be the one to come in and fill that empty void and let him wash out all the other. It's not a bath you take before you come to him. Let him be the one to do the bathing. But I, even today as a Christian, I can feel those times in my life when we want to reach for things, our finances. We want to feel security in having a certain amount of money in our hand. Those are important. But Jesus, it has to be our source. He has to be our source. Because no matter what happens, eternity is through him and his work that he did on the cross. His work he did on the cross for all sinners. That is the source. Today, if you don't know Jesus Christ, I want to ask you today. As you're in your homes, wherever you're at, if you're sitting in your car, wherever you're at, just taking a moment, you're watching this. I'm going to let this song play, and I'm going to come back in just a second. Let it minister to you today. Verse in that, I don't know, read out of those lyrics. He goes to sing there, this world has nothing for me. It really don't. And all the things we reach for here is wrong in this life. This world has nothing. And what God can give. I want to ask you today, if you don't know Jesus Christ, I want to ask you today, ask Him into your heart. Ask Him into your heart today. You can respond to me, my personal Facebook. You see me tagged to this. I would love to pray with you. I would love to connect you. I'd love to talk with you. I'd love to get you a Bible if you don't have one. You need Jesus today. Today, if you feel that thumping as I talk about Him, you feel that thumping in your chest, I've been there. I've been there. Respond. He's right where you're at. If you're alone right now, standing in your living room, you can hit your knees and ask Him, just like the song said, I need you, Jesus.
Yes.
I need you, Jesus.
Yes.
Ask Him now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Those of you with your families, I pray during this moment you'll be able to take the time to pray as we get ready to wrap it up here and I close. I pray that today have an extended time in church. Don't just move on. Have some time to talk about this sermon. Go to John. Go to John and John 4 and look it up and go to 13 to 14. Look at this whole scripture, Jesus with this woman. Talk about it a little bit. See if your kids have questions. Talk on a little bit. Learn from it. We need the Word. I challenge the church in this time that we get in our Word. We need to be in our Word. People of the Word. Chewing on it daily. I'm excited about this week. We get to meet more and share a small devotion and meet with you guys. We'll be having prayer. We'll be doing a devotion on Wednesdays. And maybe throughout the day, if you've got your phone handy, which most of us are, if we're not doing anything else, phone will be close by. Keep your eye open. I'll be getting reports of what's coming up. And if I'm going to be on for a few minutes, I'll be letting you know. Church, those of you in this moment, even us, like I say, the strong in the church right now, strong with Christ and walking with Him, in this word today, that we're checking ourselves, that's what we're reaching for. We have a world, I'm speaking to the Christian right now. We have a world that's watching. We claim Christ, we've said it, we've told it, but in this moment, where are we at? Are we rattled? Are we shaken? Are we grounded in Jesus Christ? Is He our source? Mm-hmm. I challenge you today, let Him be your source.
Yes.
Let Him be your source. And just like I said to the person that don't know Jesus, I say to the Christian, you can hit your knees right now and say, God, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, God, for ever putting this or that, these things, and if this is in place, there's those of you that I know out there today that have lost family members. You need Jesus right now. You're hurting. You're hurting. You don't have any answers to your questions, and you're hurting. You need Jesus right now. I pray you reach out to Him. Call upon Him right where you're at. Lord, I thank you today.
Thank you, Father.
I thank you for this word. I thank you, Father, that you are our source of life. God, if you're not, Lord God, show us what needs to be removed. God, in this moment, Lord God, when things are different, Lord, we're looking to you, the creator of the universe, a king of glory. We thank you right now, God, for those that right now that are out there that are sick, Lord, we pray, God, touch their bodies. Those, Lord God, that are weary or scared, Lord God, I pray, bring peace to their home. God, I pray right now through this phone that they'll be able to hear, Lord God, you are their source. God, in the midst of this, Lord God, whatever fear is trying to grip them, Lord God, break off the chain that He's trying to put up on their life, Lord God, right now. God, I pray, God, freedom in their home right now, freedom to worship you, freedom to praise you. Right now, we will not be bound by nothing that try to place by the enemy, by the demonic attack of this virus. Demonic attack of this virus, Lord God, be broken in Jesus' name. We're believers, Lord Father. We thank you for America. We thank you, Father, for our leaders, Lord God. Right now, God, that are searching for answers, Lord God. I pray, Lord Father, God, as they're in prayer, as they search, I pray, Lord God, those answers come for every one of us. For every one of us. Not a separation between groups or anything else, Lord God, but for everyone. For everyone, Lord God, as our nation searches. Thank you for our president.
Thank you,
God. Bless him, Lord God, and the team around him, Lord God. Bring answers, Lord, we pray. God, until then, Lord God, we look to you. We look to you in it all.
Yes.
We're trusting you. Yes. We just thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
God, we give you praise and glory and
honor.
We love you today.
Yes.
You are the source of our life.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Yes.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you for coming today, and we'll keep you updated. Make comments at the bottom, and I'll be looking at them and getting back with you. God bless you. I'll have a wonderful day in Jesus. Amen.